Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to place any design, such as a logo, onto a curved glass surface. For your convenience, I provided this photo as well as this logo so you can follow along. Their links are in my video's description or project files. The first step is to separate the logo from its background. Open your magic wand tool and the sample size. Increasing the sample increases the averaging of the colors of the pixels. Let's make it 5x5 average. The tolerance allows us to select a larger area at a time. The higher the value, the wider the range of pixels that Photoshop will select. Let's type in 10. Make sure contiguous is not checked. This will ensure that all the white pixels in our image will be selected. Click anywhere on the white background. Press Q on your keyboard to see our selection as a quick mask. All areas that are filled with the quick mask will be kept, while areas outside the quick mask will be deleted. If you want to retain areas that are not part of the quick mask, we'll fill it with the Paint Bucket tool. Make sure black is your foreground color. Then click inside areas you want to keep. You could also use your brush or pencil tool to do this. If you want to zoom into your image, open your zoom tool by pressing and holding the Z key on your keyboard and dragging over an area you want to zoom into. To reposition your image on the canvas, press and hold the space bar as you drag the image. Then open back up your Paint Bucket tool and click inside the white areas you don't want deleted. If you make a mistake, just press Ctrl or Command Z to undo the last step. If there are areas that are too tight to fill in with the Paint Bucket tool, open your Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. Pick a soft or hard point. I'll make its size 6 pixels. Make the hardness 100% and the opacity 100%. Then, draw over those areas to fill them in. To fit your image back onto the canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Then press Q to revert it back into a selection. Unlock the background and press the Delete key to delete the areas outside the selection. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Press V to open your Move tool and drag the logo on top of the tab of your photo. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To adjust its size, press Ctrl or Command T to open our Transform tool. Go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it in. Position it over the glass mug. If it seems to be sticking while you move it, go to View. Snap is probably checked. Click it to deactivate it. Once it's sized and positioned to your liking, press Enter or Return. We'll save it as a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as replace it with another logo without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Open the Transform tool, and at the top, click the Warp Transform icon. Open the Warp Presets list, and for this image, click Squeeze. Hover your cursor over Bend, and click and drag it to the left to warp the Transform's bounding box until its right and left sides match the shape of the edges of the glass mug. We can adjust the Warp Transform further by opening back the Warp Presets and clicking Custom. Drag any of the Transform's anchor points to warp our logo until the Transform's bounding box approximates the perspective of the glass mug. Then press Enter or Return. Since the photo isn't as sharp as the logo, let's blur the logo slightly. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. For this photo, let's blur the logo 0.5 pixels. Change the blend mode to linear light. We can now see that the glass highlights are reflecting off the logo as well. Next, we'll decrease the vibrancy of the logo's color to match the photo's vibrancy. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. We want the adjustment layer to affect just the logo and not the background. However, since adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, we'll need to clip it or restrict it to the logo directly below it. The quickest way to do this is to click the Clipping Mask icon. Another way is to go to Layer and Create Clipping Mask. For this logo, let's decrease the vibrance to -60 and decrease the saturation to -20. The difference between vibrance and saturation is this. Vibrance mainly affects the intensity of muted colors, while saturation affects the color intensity of all the colors in the image. Next, we'll blend the logo with the background. Double-click an empty area of the layer of the logo to open its layer style window. We'll use Blend If to blend the logo with the photo. Basically, Blend If uses the luminosity of pixels. The current layer is also named This Layer in older versions. This represents the active layer in our Layers panel, which in our case is the logo. The underlying layer represents all the layers below the active layer, which in this case is the photo. When we move the sliders of the current layer, it'll clip off the shadows or the highlights of the logo. Conversely, when we move the sliders of the underlying layer, it'll punch the shadows or the highlights of the background through the logo. We could blend it smoothly by placing our cursor in the middle of the icon and pressing Alt or Option. When you click it, this splits the icon in half. Dragging the inside half to the center blends the highlights of the photo smoothly. For this image, let's drag it somewhere between 125 and 130. Split the underlying shadows icon and drag the inside half to approximately 73. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.